Doctor, you are a physician and surgeon duly licensed to practice under the laws of the state of New York?
Yes, I am.
What medical school did you attend?
University of Syracuse.
You have been practicing medicine since 1941, is that correct, Doctor? Internal medicine and diagnosis. Did there come a time that you examined the plaintiff in this case, Robert Greenstein?
Yes, I did, sir.
What were your findings then, please?
He complained when he came to me of having severe headaches. My examination consisted of doing a neurological examination on him. At that time, other than the fact he had some tenderness on the side of his head, the left side of his head, I found nothing neurologically. I continued to observe him.
Did you observe him for a period of time?
Yes, I saw him at regular intervals, at least 1 or 2 weeks for at least 3.5 months, and we watched him and observed him for any possible subsequent complications of a head injury, such as a hematoma, blood clots, or a development called subdural hematoma.
What were his other complaints?
Lightheadedness was another complaint, dizziness, and there were occasional blackouts of short duration.
What is your diagnosis, doctor, of Mr. Greenberg's condition?
Well, I always felt that he had what we call a post-concussion syndrome. Many people feel that is a nebulous expression because it is a symptomatic entity rather than something that can be definitely ascertained by diagnostic procedures. If the patient continues to have headaches, and if it dates back to the accident, continues to have other cerebral symptoms like lightheadedness and blackout, we do feel that it is something that you can't pick up oftentimes on examination, but pathologically it is probably due to some trauma where there is small vessel damage present.
At that time, doctor, what signal did he exhibit to you? How did he feel?
When I saw him, he was stuporous. He had abrasions on the left side of his nose and the right supraorbital region. He was restless and irritable.
Doctor, I understand that you followed him up and you made further tests. Would you tell us just what you did and what his progress was, if you will?
He had an electroencephalogram which showed that he had irregular slow form waves bilaterally. It was an abnormal record. When I last examined him, he was complaining of morning headaches about once or twice a week, described as a sensation of fullness, and within 5 to 10 minutes, a moderate ache.
Doctor, assuming he complains of occasional loss of memory, could this be related to the injury he sustained?
Yes, I think that could be related.
Assume, doctor, he complains of the fact that he had insomnia. He must get up many times and he still takes these headache pills. Could this type of reaction be related to a head injury of this type?
Well, you see, he can complain of 1,000 things. They could all be related. Factually, it is hard to prove.
Now, doctor, when he had this skull fracture, the brain, of course, is not anchored to anything. It is free-flowing in the head. Is that correct?
That is correct.
It runs from one end to the other one, and shock waves now go through this brain, do they not?
Very good analysis, yes.
Shock waves could cause related damage to other portions of the brain.
It is not the shock. It is the fact that when he bounces backwards, his brain also bounces forward in a contra-coup manner.
In any event, doctor, do you think this man is malingering?
No, I don't think this man is malingering at all. I think he has an occasional headache. I think he may have an occasional memory lapse, but this is not contraindicative of the type of work he does.
Doctor, do you feel you should do another encephalogram before you could give an opinion?
I think he should have another test because this last one was still abnormal, and if the present one is still abnormal, then he should be on some medication to prevent a seizure.
Are you able to state, doctor, that the complaints made by the plaintiff are causally related to the injury?
I feel they are. I feel that these complaints are related to that date, yes.
It says 250.
Yeah, 250.
250?
Yeah.
How is it?
I had one big drop where I dropped 10 words or something, but other than that, it didn't hurt.
Good.